So over the past couple of years, there've been some crazy videos coming from Linus Tech Tips and TLD about really expensive storage solutions. And as fun as the videos are to watch, they're just not feasible for the regular content creator like myself or anyone else who can't afford $30,000 to $50,000. I wanted to figure out if I could find something that was just off the shelf that would work for my needs. And I came upon the Synology DS1819 Plus. This is a $900 NAS solution. Now, the good thing about this is that it doesn't cost a lot of money to start off with. You can fill up all 8 drives with 14 terabyte hard drives like I did, or if you're on a tighter budget, you can start off with something smaller. Now, my unit has 8 bays, but I can also connect 2 more of these together to give me a potential of 24 bays to work with. Right now, they're all filled up with 14 terabyte Seagate Iron Wolf drives. It gives me about 85 terabytes after RAID 5 kicks in. But the most important reason to buy a NAS is not so much for like the backup solution, but is the ability to work off of it. Because this is in RAID 5, and because I have a 10 gigabyte NIC inside of here, I can edit my videos directly off this NAS. Now, right now, when I run a speed test, I'm getting about 1,000 megabytes read and about 500 to 600 write. That is perfect for a 2-editor solution. Pulling drives in and out is super easy. Just press the button in, and as you can see here, like I mentioned before, I have that 14 terabyte drive. These drives are meant for backup solutions. These are not drives you buy for your regular consumer computer. These are meant to be read and written on consistently over a long period of time. Getting inside is also really easy. It's just a couple of screws on the back, and all you have to do is pull up the top of the case. And once you're in, you can see where you have that PCIe lane. So as I mentioned, I have the 10 gigabyte NIC installed right here, so 2 computers can hook up to the back. But if down the road I find that I'm the only one personally editing off of it, I can pull this out, put the cache drive in, and get faster read and write speeds. On the back, you also, oh sh**. On the back, I also have tons of I/O. I have 3 USB ports to hook up external drives. I have 2 eSATA ports, so if I want to connect directly to my computer or daisy chain another one of these, I can. You have 4 1 gigabyte ports, so you can hook up different computers to it. It's good to like push files to save on this, but I wouldn't edit off of a 1 gigabyte port. Now, obviously this is not as expensive or flexible as a $50,000 solution. It's not meant to be, but for 2 to 4 people, it is perfect. It completely eliminates the need to pass hard drives back and forth. The ability to access this anywhere in the world is also really helpful. So if I'm in the studio and I need to upload something into my footage, I can do it from my phone. I can do it from another computer. I don't have to send it to Google Drive first, then re-download it onto my computer. But one of the most important features is noise. This thing is ridiculously silent. There's a 250 watt power supply in here, and you pair that with an Intel Atom 4-core processor, it's not gonna get that loud. So anyways, I know this solution is not as vibrant or extravagant compared to some of the bigger creators showcasing their $80,000 setups, but I think for a lot of people, this is a lot more feasible. For like $900 for the enclosure itself, plus the cost of hard drives, you have something that's going to basically take care of your storage solutions. You can grow with this. So if your business grows, you can grow this as well. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.